Welcome, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today I'm discussing, can 5G radiation make you sick? So this is something that we know that EMF exposure, so non-native EMF, meaning not the natural radiation we get from the sun or the electromagnetism from the earth, but from artificially man-made EMF or EMR, electromagnetic radiation, can it make you sick? And there's a lot of debate on this subject. Well, there's something in our body called VGCCs, and these are voltage-gated calcium channels. And what they do is they allow for calcium to enter the cells. So this is a normal phenomenon, but what happens when we're exposed to this electromagnetic radiation is that too much calcium gets into our cells, and this can have a negative impact on our health. This has actually been studied, and in this study by Martin Paul, what they looked at was the mechanism of how EMF radiation can affect our body and our health, and it was the mechanism of the VGCCs, the voltage-gated calcium channels, that had the most impact on the effect of our cells and our health. So next I'm going to talk about the symptoms of EMF radiation and from 5G, but stay tuned right until the end of the video where I'm going to share a few tips on how to decrease your EMF exposure. So some of the symptoms of 5G radiation and EMF radiation could include headaches, whether that's chronic headaches, tension headaches, migraine headaches. This could be related to that electromagnetic radiation, as well as fatigue and simply not having enough energy, as well as muscle aches and muscle twitches. This could be related to that EMR, as well as insomnia and sleep disorders, not being able to sleep well or feeling refreshed when you wake up after a night of sleep, but also weight gain can be related to 5G and this EMR. So now I promised I would share some tips as to how to decrease your EMF exposure. So one of the things that's interesting, if you look at a lot of the symptoms related to EMF radiation, they're related to a magnesium deficiency. So by taking and ensuring you're getting enough magnesium in your diet, this is a really important way to block that calcium. Magnesium is actually a natural calcium channel blocker and will really help to mitigate your risk against that EMF exposure. So I have a lot more tips on how to decrease your risk and your exposure to EMF, so be sure to check out my episode called Secrets of How EMFs Affect Our Health, Part 1 and Part 2, and you're going to get a lot of tips in those videos. Now, if you've learned something new today, I hope that you share this video with your friends. Also, I'd like to hear from you. Do you think that you have some exposure to EMFs and 5G, and maybe you've got some other symptoms that I didn't mention? I'd love to hear about it in the comments, so we can really help each other and help to educate ourselves about these negative impacts of EMF radiation on our health. So if you're new to my channel, make sure that you're subscribed. Also, click that bell to turn on the post notification so you always get my newest and latest uploads. And remember to always take care of your good health and to do it naturally. Thanks for watching today.